The next thing to talk about is what's at the heart of our product. The heart of our product is two circuit boards that drive the sensor pair. And what we have here, as I mentioned a few moments ago, are two reference grade platinum sensors. They happen to be 100 ohm platinum sensors. But they're two reference-grade platinum sensors wound on a support, and that platinum sensor wound is called an RTD. So you have two RTDs, but for industrialization, you have 316L stainless protecting it. So what you see is stainless steel. What's inside is a winding of platinum. We use the same platinum that the National Institute of Standards uses for their platinum, for their resistance standards. So they're using this type of platinum as reference standards. So it doesn't drift. Now that's not unique to us. What's unique to us is this baby, the circuitry. Now, when we started the business, I mentioned to you Robert Trescott was tasked to change the technology. Well, there are two sensors in our meter. Here's how our meter works. One sensor, the longer one, is self-heated by the electronics. The shorter one measures the gas temperature, meaning the temperature in the pipe. The circuit's job is to maintain a constant temperature difference between the heated sensor and the reference sensor. The temperature measurement we call the reference sensor. Right? So imagine if molecules start flowing across this heated sensor, meaning there's flow in the pipe. Well, the molecules carry heat away from the sensor. And the heat that's carried away, those little molecules are sucking heat, carrying heat right off the sensor. And guess what? It cools it down. And notice my hand's getting closer. What that means is the heated sensor just got cooled down. The circuit gets imbalanced and pumps more current to reheat up the sensor. We actually measure the wattage, the milliwatts necessary to do that. See, the energy carried away, ladies and gentlemen, is the energy that has to be replaced. So when you see the milliwatts go up on our display, or if our reps are visiting us and they see us calibrating and you see the milliwatts go up on our calibration facility as we increase the flow rate, that's because it takes more energy to maintain the delta T, the constant temperature, when you have more flow rate. And what happens is I want you to think about a seesaw, that when there's flow, you're imbalanced. And then it takes about a second to get back in balance. So for the bridge to balance, it takes about a second, 1 second per time constant. And the difference in temperature has to be restored, and the meter's happy, the bridge is happy. Okay? Now, if the world were always in constant temperature, that's the end of the story, but it's not. The gas temperature is going to change. Because we're based on heat transfer, and what I was about to say is that output, the energy needed to maintain the delta T is proportional to mass flow. So in the simple example, hypothetically the temperature is constant, the flow starts increasing, and let's say it increases to 100 cubic feet per minute in a 4-inch pipe, then the meter is going to read 100. How does it do it? Well, it starts cooling down as soon as you turn the flow on, and then eventually within 1 second, the energy, the delta T is restored because a lot more milliwatts is going out. That milliwatts is proportional to mass flow. In other words, the more milliwatts, the more mass flow. So the more flow rate, the more milliwatts. What's happening is that's your output, and that output's proportional to mass flow. Your milliwatts is proportional to mass flow. What does that mean? That means you have a signal, but what do you do with the signal? We linearize it so that you have SCFM or SCFH, not just double aughts. Okay? You have both, which is a feature we'll talk about shortly. So, back to what is our meter measure? It measures the mass flow due to molecules carrying heat away, and essentially our device is maintaining a constant temperature, and the output, in order to maintain the constant temperature, represents the gas mass flow. Yes, we have to calibrate the meter, we'll talk about that later. So, makes sense. More energy, more mass flow, it tries to cool down. We pump more current, essentially more wattage, to replace the lost energy carried away. So, we are a heat transfer device. Look at the last page of any of the instruction manuals, and it describes this. We're a heat transfer device. Now, when you have a temperature change, let's say the flow is constant. Let's say there's 100 pounds per minute maintained in some application. There's a control of some sort. It could be a variable frequency drive. Some industries maintain flow rate through feedback control. And let's say they have some device that maintains this 1,000 pounds per hour, for example. Well, guess what? Over the course of a day, that 1,000 pounds per hour gas might heat up. Well, they're correcting because they have a control system locking in 1,000 pounds per hour. How does our meter succeed in reading the 1,000 pounds an hour when it gets warmer and warmer and warmer? Well, that happens because the reference sensor is driven up when it gets warmer and driven down, so you don't see a change. In other words, we have a reference sensor correcting for temperature changes. So, heated sensor, that's called our flow sensor. The temperature sensor is called our reference sensor. The flow sensor measures the flow rate. The reference sensor compensates for the temperature changes.